I'm at the Cornell store in Ithaca, New York, and I want to read from The Song of Solomon by Toni Morrison. Chapter 1. The North Carolina Mutual Life Insurance agent promised to fly from Mercy to the other side of Lake Superior at 3 o'clock. 2 days before the event was to take place, he tacked a note on the door of his little yellow house. At 3 p.m. on Wednesday, the 18th of February, 1931, I will take off from Mercy, fly away on my own wings. Please forgive me. I loved you all. Signed, Robert Smith, insurance agent. Mr. Smith didn't draw as big a crowd as Lindbergh had 4 years earlier. Not more than 40 or 50 people showed up because it was already 11 o'clock in the morning on the very Wednesday he had chosen for his flight before anybody read the note. At that time of day, during the middle of the week, word of mouth news just lumbered along. Children were in school, men were at work, and most of the women were fastening their corsets and getting ready to see what tails or entrails the butcher might be giving away. Only the unemployed, the self-employed, and the very young were available, deliberately available because they'd heard about it, or accidentally available because they happened to be walking at that exact moment in the shore end of Not Doctor Street, a name the post office did not recognize. The Cornell store supports freedom of expression.